Coming home late night, I've been sleeping past daylight. I'm waking up, you're not by my side. Baby, that ain't right. I wanna be there with you. Really
do- Morning, everybody. It is 5:30. My glasses are crooked. It's 5:30 in the morning. It is officially my daughter's first day back to school. Yesterday was actually her first day, but because if you seen her previous video, we ended up in the emergency room because she was sick. She stayed home yesterday. So come along with us. Let's get this day started. I'm about to take care of my hygiene and hop in the shower. So let's go.
London, it's the first day of school. Are you excited? Wake up, wake up, wake up. Are you excited? No?
Right, so it is 6 o'clock. I am dressed. I just woke London up. She's about to get dressed. You may hear her cat crying. But yeah, let's get this day started.
All right, so let's go ahead and get London's clothes pulled out. Typically, she could do this herself, but I try to speed her up in the morning because London moves a little bit slow. But she's just wearing her shorts. We have her uniform shirt, and then we have they have to wear a coordinating belt. They're not really strict on the particular shoes that they wear. So we're gonna grab her sneakers. This is where I get to get creative because otherwise she has this uniform. So they're not strict on the shoes. So yeah, this is what London will be wearing.
All right, so we're gonna start unpacking London's lunch. We're gonna fill up her water bottle. As you can see, we have the coldest water bottle. We love this water bottle. Next, we're gonna use our new Bentgo stainless steel lunchbox. These things are pretty heavy and durable, let me tell you. London requested sushi for her first day of school, so mommy obliged. I am going to throw some edamame in her lunchbox. And yes, she's only 8. How many 8-year-olds do you know request sushi and edamame? I have an egg roll that I'm gonna add in, and then I have some sushi that I picked up from a local store. This is spicy crab rolls. And then I'm just gonna add it in. I didn't feel like making any at home, so I'm just trying to figure out how to situate it inside of the Bentgo lunchbox. Once I've got everything situated, I'm just gonna add in a small cucumber salad. I'm adding some jalapeno everything but the bagel seasoning. And on the cucumber salad, I put some chili crisp and some ginger dressing. And that's pretty much it for her first day of school lunch. We're going to pack everything up. I do have some ice packs that you see me adding here. Those are Bentgo ice packs as well. So I placed 2 on the bottom and then 1 on the top. So basically her whole lunch is pretty much covered. The Bentgo fits right inside of the Bentgo lunch bag. We just went all Bentgo this year for the most part, and it fits perfectly in there. There's not a lot of space, but as you can see, it does fit perfectly in there, but you still have room to add a lot more things. We have one of these splash filled lemonades. We're trying that out for the first time. This is a treat we picked up. It's some beef sticks and some cheese from Aldi's. We have this zero sugar Chobani drink from Publix for her morning snack. And then we add some sushi inside, seaweed inside. We have her silverware, her napkin, and we always add in a little affirmation card of the day. Isn't it so cute? But yeah, that's what London is having for lunch. All right, there's my girl, my third grader. She's officially off to school.
We have made it to school. My girl is headed to third grade. We're just gonna come and say a quick prayer that London has an amazing school year, Dear Heavenly Father, we come right now in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus, Lord God. We ask you to heal London from everything that she's going through. You know the desires of her heart. We ask that you touch her from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet, Lord God. Bless her. Bless all the students, Lord God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we're going to have an amazing, successful year. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. See you guys soon.
Right, so I got my tripod. I'm like, that's much better. You get a much better angle. This is much more comfortable for me. So I did pick up one order after I dropped my daughter off at school. So now I'm just sitting here waiting on another order. Y'all, I'm tired. I have been up since, and excuse me, I have a cold. So I've been up since 3:30 this morning because my daughter slept with me. Whenever she has these episodes, I like to let her sleep with me, and she sleeps bad, y'all. But anyway, I got me some Starbucks, so hopefully that will perk me up, and hopefully these orders will start coming through. Before I blink, it'll be time to pick my daughter back up for school. She's not going to do after school just yet, but in a few weeks she will. But that time just flies by real quick. Guys, so I'm trying to keep up with these videos. OMG, it has been a crazy morning. I've been working. I'm getting rid of some things in my home, so I've been meeting people, selling it online. So I just been busy. I'm trying to keep up with these videos. I just had the craziest delivery. I have three chargers and my car charger. My phone died in the middle of an Uber Eats delivery, so I didn't know where to go. I had to go all the way to Walmart to go get a charger, to be able to call the customer and say, hey, I'm still headed to you. By the time I was heading to the customer, Uber rerouted the order back to the store. So I called the customer, I'm like, they want me to take it back to the store. And she started crying like, no, I'm 80 years old. I don't have any food in my house. I'm like, I'm not taking this order back to the store. So thankfully she trusted me enough to give me her address, because once they rerouted back to the store, you can't even see their address anymore. And I was able to take the lady her groceries because, yeah, that was crazy. But yeah. And just like that, I am in the pickup line waiting to pick up London. That time flies by. Oh my goodness. Like, she starts at 8:00 and gets out at 2:45. Those little hours flew by. I did get a chance to do a few things and make some deliveries, but way not enough time. So I can't wait till she starts after school. Thankfully, we don't have a horrible after school pickup line, but we passed three more schools to get here, and their lines are horrible, and they kind of impact our pickup line. So they have to have the police directing the traffic. Oh my, sorry, this cold is bothering me, but I got London a snack, and I'm sure she'll have water in her water bottle. So I'll let you guys know once I pick her up. We were gonna do some deliveries, but it's about to storm outside, so I don't know if we'll be staying out here. And I don't know, she'll probably have homework. Her school does not play first day, second day, third day. They be giving them kids homework, so we shall see in a minute. All right, so we have secured London from her first day of school. Of course, the first thing she's gonna do is pick up snacks. How was your first day of school?
Amazing.
10 out of 10.
10.
Day wasn't long enough though, but all right, let's get our afternoon started.
All right, London is back. Let's check it out and see what she ate. These kids, these are definitely thawed out. She drank some of her yogurt. She didn't drink it all. We have our utensils back. All of the ice packs. She has her little affirmation card. And let's see what she ate. She didn't eat all her edamame. She ate her egg rolls. She ate her sushi. She didn't touch the little ginger or the wasabi. Can't tell if she ate some of the cucumber salad or not, but she did very, very good. So yeah, that's what she ate. All right, so once I go through London's lunchbox, the first thing I do is I wash her lunchboxes.
and get them fresh. I don't let the food sit in there because I don't want any mold or anything like that. I've never experienced mold in her lunch boxes, and I really don't want to experience it. As you can see, her ice is still in her coldest water bottle. This water bottle is no joke. And as a matter of fact, it's kind of molded in there, so I gotta add some hot water in there and get it out right now. We are having leftovers for dinner, so thank goodness. We were gonna do some deliveries, but we came home since it's storming. But this is London's routine. She'll typically have a snack. Normally it's the time she does homework, but they don't have any homework right now. She's finishing up her yogurt that she didn't finish this morning. She's finishing up her yogurt that she didn't finish up this morning. And then she has some of those chicken ranch crackers. Immediately, as soon as we come home from school, we come out of our uniform. We don't play in our school clothes, so.
I feel comfortable like this.
And she feels comfortable. It is pretty early, but London said she wanted to have her dinner so that she can take her bath and relax. So it sounded a-okay with me. I've been up since 3 a.m. and I am exhausted. So this is what she's having for dinner. We have some buffalo chicken wings, some rice, and we have some Brussels sprouts. They're actually Brussels sprouts from Trader Joe's with Parmesan cheese. All right, London is running her bath water. She's put the little colorful things in there to change the color of her water. And yeah, when she gets out, I'll get in, and mommy is signing off for the night at that point. All right, London is officially in the bed. Woohoo! Yay! It is 7:30 p.m. She has it till 8 o'clock, and it is bedtime. She gets to relax and watch TV for about 30 minutes before bed. This concludes our video.
We'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace out.
All right, it is 8:30. London is out for the count. We are signing off. Good night, everybody.
I'm waking up, you're not by my side. Baby, that ain't right. I wanna be there with you. I really do be missing you. Everything I do is for you. And